Mikey, we obviously know that you're involved with the under-21s and the strength and conditioning side of things and the coaching side of things, but how did you get involved in it in the first place?
I suppose it would have started off in Tralee IT, where I would have studied under the likes of Pat Fanning and Joe O'Connor. Joe O'Connor's now a senior strength and conditioning coach, and he's had been involved with senior and county teams, international athletes, and it was kind of a job or a profession that I wanted to get into. I didn't see working in sport as a job, so it kind of initiated there. I was given a teaching degree, but had no real interest in teaching once I got into it, so did a master's in strength and conditioning in LIT, and from there I was kind of always, during my academia, I was always worked in the practical side of things, so eventually it kind of just evolved naturally, and I find myself working with Limerick 21s this year, after working with a couple of other GA teams down through the last few years.
Yeah, and I did. I spied on your LinkedIn page and an impressive CV. So you've worked a lot with a lot of different GAA sides.
Yeah, I suppose I started off really in 2012. I got a chance to intern with my football team under Andy O'Neill. After that, I got called in with Clare in 21 in 2013, working with the now senior management of Clare hurling team. And they were great to me, and it was a great learning experience. And fortunately enough, we had team of All-Stars the same year, and we won the U21 All-Ireland. From there then I went back in with the footballers as head SNC in 2014, 2015, and again that was a huge learning experience. It was the first time I'd been involved with a senior team, and the first time I had control of a senior team. And then I got involved with the hurling side of Limerick, so now I find myself with Limerick 21s. Unfortunately again, we're in All-Ireland final in 2017, and looking forward to it.
And involved with the academy as well, which was a job you did last year as well, so looking after a lot of age groups and a lot of work there.
I looked after the 14s to the minor last year. I suppose the pinnacle was getting to an All-Ireland minor final. Unfortunately, we came up against a good Tipperary team. However, my work was made a lot easier in that I had Carbro before me, who was Carbro Carlon, who is now with the Arsenal Ladies football team. And Dara Droog's in that position now. So what we're seeing under 21 and senior level is we have players coming in who have the basic understanding of the gym work, the understanding of the nutritional side of things, and we're getting a much more developed player coming through the academy, which helps our job at 21's level and senior level greatly.
And looking at the 21s, they've had a lot of games so far, and they have to play with their clubs as well, a lot of them with colleges, so it's a hectic season for them. How do you stay on top of them, and what do you cover with them?
This is the most difficult part of the job, and particularly in February and March, where you have some clubs that are starting up, you have players involved with colleges, football and hurling, clubs, football and hurling, and then so we've a lot of our panel are playing senior hurling with Limerick. And so trying to get that kind of training load right is extremely difficult, and it's much about monitoring and informing players of what is too much and what isn't, or what they need to do to achieve a good level of fitness. And we have them filling in monitoring apps once a week where they detail their sleep, how much training they do, how many games they're playing a week, and what their nutrition is like. So they fill that in every week or every couple of days, and that's really informs us of how they're feeling and how many games they have, how much training they've done, and we have to make educated decisions then based on that information. So players coming to us, he's had two college games, he's played a league game with Limerick, and he's had a club training session. Then the right thing for us to do is not to train that player when he comes to us on a Sunday for 21's training. It's basic common sense a lot of the time, but the thing about common sense is not that common a lot of the time. But communication with GAA in general is poor, so once we get between ourselves and John Kiely, get communication right at senior level, trying to communicate well with the college coaches, and a lot of this overtraining and overload can be avoided.
Is that something that could hurt them going forward if they're only young fellas coming in? Obviously, they're all under 21. Is that something you're worried about, maybe them burning out going forward?
It is. I think we've well managed in Limerick in that with good pathways of communication opened up. You see ACL injuries have increased dramatically in the last few years. We're not exactly sure why. Players are better conditioned than they've ever been. So load must be a factor. It is a worry, but I just think you have to be good at monitoring it. Again, we're looking at senior level, we have GPS, we have heart rate monitors, we're well looked after, and we're well equipped to look after training load. But sometimes with training load, it's as much about getting to know the player, developing a relationship, how are you feeling today, are you tired, have you an injury, just setting up the game communication pathways. And a lot of the time once the player trusts you, he'll come to you, he'll let you know what's going on in his life, and a lot of these injuries and this overload can be avoided very simply.
Is that something that could hurt them going forward if they're only young fellas coming in, obviously they're all under 21, is that something you're worried about, maybe them burning out going forward?
It is. I think we've well managed in Limerick in that with good pathways of communication opened up. You see ACL injuries have increased dramatically in the last few years. We're not exactly sure why. Players are better conditioned than they've ever been. So load must be a factor. It is a worry, but I just think you have to be good at monitoring it. Again, we're looking at senior level, we have GPS, we have heart rate monitors. We're well looked after, and we're well equipped to look after training load. But sometimes with training load, it's as much about getting to know the player, developing a relationship, how are you feeling today, are you tired, have you an injury, just setting up the game communication pathways. And a lot of the time once the player trusts you, he'll come to you, he'll let you know what's going on in his life. And a lot of these injuries and this overload can be avoided very simply.
And you're involved in the coaching side as well, so you kind of do the two jobs. Is this a lot of work for you?
I suppose it's a lot of work, but again, working in sport isn't really work for me, so I love every minute of it. Yeah, do a bit of hurling coaching as well, but I enjoy that a lot, in that what it means is I can develop scenarios in training to make players fitter through hurling. So we do very little isolated fitness training. We do a lot of it through small sided games where there's match intensity, there's match pressure, and players are making decisions under pressure. And I find that works a lot better. So in a lot of ways I find it much easier that I have a role in coaching and a role in fitness, because I can bring the two together. And it might be a bit more difficult if I was trying to put my thoughts to a hurling coach who might have his own ideas. So I find it work. It's a bit of work, but they both work well together.
Yeah, and coming in as well, working with a seriously talented group of hurlers, and also a great manager in Pat Donnelly, so it must be a lot easier than some jobs.
Yeah, we've fantastic bunch of players, and there are a bunch of players that have experienced a lot of success underage. Unfortunately, the last minor to Kenny, but a lot of them have come ones that are in 2015. Now they're an experienced bunch, and they really do drive. They drive behaviour and they drive performance themselves. And you see with the best cultures, the best sporting cultures around the world, like the All Blacks, the best cultures are player driven, and that's what we're trying to achieve with Limerick, that the players who drive the culture, they drive the performance standards. And as you say, working with Pat Donnelly, fantastic manager, often a man of little words, but when he speaks, the players really listen, and he's a shrewd knowledge of every player, I find. He's always watching them, being in the gym, on the training field, in games, how they carry themselves outside of training, what they're doing, their social lives and their working lives. Takes a real interest in the players, and I think the players really appreciate that and respond to that.
Yeah, and coming up to the final now as well, is it kind of more or less the same training coming up to it, or because you've so many games behind you, is it a bit lighter, or what way do you approach it?
We usually 2 weeks out from a game, which is this week coming in, we'll have a small heavier than usual, and game week will be often light. However, we're coming after the back of the club championship weekend now, so a lot of the players will have played games on Friday, Saturday and Sunday. A lot of them were heavy games. You'll get a few knocks out of them, which is natural. We'll come in Tuesday night. We'll do a session of high intensity, but we'll probably cut down the duration of it, and just go through things we've identifying the video analysis that we need to improve on from the goal again when we begin it.
And just finally on yourself, you're obviously doing a PhD and you're involved with the coaching side of things.
Yeah.
Is management or anything on the horizon for you in the future, do you think?
No, I think I'd leave that to Pat. I much prefer the coaching side of it. In being a manager, I'd say Pat's probably on the phone 10, 15, 20 times a day, and that really wouldn't work for me. I love the coaching, the hands-on side of it. And to be a manager, you really have to be good logistically, and your management has to be crucial. And I'd be a negative kind of a person at best, so I think the coaching side might suit me better.
So if you don't have the social skills for management, as you say, coaching though, at continuing your coaching career, you'd be looking to do that?
Yeah, I think you can always develop your coaching. I'm still only early in my coaching career, and we're always looking the likes of the Munsters, you're looking at soccer, you're looking at other sports, you can pick up anything. And I find communication is always an area you can improve on. How you convey a message, how you get a message across. Can you get the players to solve the problem rather than you just giving them the information and they're trying to lap it up? So it's a continuous process, and hopefully you can continue to involve us. My years get on.
Perfect. Thanks so much, Mikey.